UN Secretary-General Dag Hammarskjold boards a plane in New York for Cairo, where he will take personal charge of the explosive three-cornered war in Egypt. He will be greeted by the shambles left in Port Said by the joint British-French invasion. This is where amphibious and paratroop forces struck a few days before. Now the city is quiet under a ceasefire order issued by the UN, pending the arrival of the units of the newly created United Nations Police Force from their staging area in Naples. Even as troops are immobilized by the truce, threats of intervention by Russian volunteers are heard from Moscow, a move which President Eisenhower says will be opposed by the United States with complete support of UN decisions. With the arrival of Canadian General E.L.M. Burns, who will command the UN force of 6,000, preparations for keeping the peace swing into high gear. Work on clearing the canal, now cluttered with 25 sunken ships, will begin immediately. Peace hovers precariously in the wings.